Hello viewers, my name is Asif, and on behalf of Atlantic Lubricants, we're starting a new series which is called Exploration with Atlantic. Our first topic for today is viscosity, the numbers which are written on the can by SAE. Let's go to the video and see more details on that. Okay, as we were discussing the SAE, firstly, let's delve into the identity of our SAE. It is the Society of Automotive Engineers, a US-based organization established in the early 1900s, marking the inception of the modern vehicle engine era. Over the years, it has evolved into the comprehensive learning organization for numerous automotive professionals. The SAE plays a pivotal role in setting industry standards with a specific focus on parameters related to multi-grade oils and their viscosities, areas of particular interest to us. Understanding SAE grades is quite straightforward. It involves two numbers. The initial number is associated with cold temperature performance, where the W can be interpreted as representing winter. The designation emerged from the historical practices, particularly in harsh environments like Canada or certain parts of North America. In those times, changing the lubricant in your car according to the season was necessary because the extreme cold temperatures rendered standard grades ineffective. The second digit pertains to regular services. And in our context, we are discussing the 20 grade. It's important to note that there are also monograde oils exemplified by natural gas stationary engines operating at SAE 40. Unlike multigrade oils, these are not versatile across temperature ranges. However, for the majority of passenger vehicles, whether powered by petrol or diesel, a multigrade system is employed. So in the instance, we have an oil blend that complies with the low temperature specification of a 0W grade and the 100 degree requirement of a 20 grade. Viscosity typically decreases with rising temperature. The 0W grade would exhibit a certain profile, while the 20 grade would appear somewhat thicker across the temperature range. The 0W20 blend, however, smoothly transitions between the two, acting as 0W at low temperature and shifting to a 20 at higher temperatures. The capability is achieved through the incorporation of viscosity modifiers, a specific class of additives. Now let's explore the formal classification system. The initial observation will be that winter grades adhere to specific criteria, while standard grades adhere to a distinct set of criteria. Let's delve a bit deeper into these criteria to discern the differences. To begin, let's examine the specification of low temperature, winter grades, and decipher these significances. Considering an engine in operational mode, lubricant circulates throughout, ensuring the lubrication of crucial components. However, during periods of inactivity, there's a limited amount of lubricant in the system to safeguard the engine. While some lubricant resides in the oil pan and the majority tends to drain out into the sump. In colder condition, our focus lies on initiating the engine and ensuring its protection during startup. The measure of this cold crank performance is known as low temperature cranking viscosity. It gauges the engine ability to smoothly turn over when the ignition is engaged, a critical consideration in frigid temperatures where the viscosity of a lubricant significantly increases. Additionally, we seek optimal pumping performance, particularly with the oil pump. It's crucial to ensure its capability to efficiently pump out oil at low temperatures to reach all parts of the engine. For instance, consider the cams, a heavily loaded component even when dry. If oil fails to reach the cam and they operate without lubrication for any duration, significant damage can occur. Thus, it's imperative to guarantee that the lubricant swiftly flows to all critical areas. Lastly, we don't solely characterize a winter grade based on its cold temperature performance. It must also demonstrate efficacy at operating temperatures. Consequently, a minimum viscosity is established at 100 degrees Celsius. As we transition to the realm of high temperature performance, we persist in establishing a minimum specification for viscosity at 100 degrees. Yet, we also establish an upper limit, and this is essential because we still necessitate adequate viscosity to safeguard all engine components. As it surpasses that threshold, it progresses to a higher grade. The ultimate assessment is the high shear viscosity test, commonly known as the HTHS test. This aspect has gained increased significance in recent years, especially concerning fuel economy and consumption. Essentially, it aims to examine the impact of temporary viscosity loss under high shear condition. For instance, around the piston rings, viscosity modifiers may temporarily lose their ability to maintain viscosity. Therefore, high shear viscosity tests serve as a gauge for the temporary degradation in VI viscosity index performance. We hope you gained some information which we shared with you on viscosities by SAE. If you have any queries, any questions on new topics, write to us in the comment and we will come back to you as soon as possible. Looking forward for more videos to come, please subscribe to our channel and we'll be with you.